Hey, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on BMW N20 engine problems. Jumping right into things, the BMW N20 was produced from 2011 until 2017. It's a 2-liter turbocharged inline four engine, the first modern inline four turbo engine from BMW, and began largely being phased out by the newest inline four 2-liter engine from BMW, the BMW B48. So after 2017, the N20 was totally cut off, and now everything has moved on to the B48. But anyway, jumping right into common engine problems for the BMW N20. Number one, we have the timing chain guide problems. The main issue with the N20 timing chain guides is they were made from a polymer that tended to wear down fairly quickly and fail if the timing did skip or jump far enough that the pistons and valves could then collide with each other and cause catastrophic engine damage, if not complete engine failure, and the need to completely replace the N20 with a new engine. When this all came up, BMW redesigned the timing chain in January 2015. For a number of cars, they also offered a 7-year, 70,000-mile extended warranty. That provided some resolve for the N20 timing chain problems, and for the most part, most N20s on the road today, if you're looking to purchase an N20, if they did have faulty timing chains and guides, they likely already failed and have been replaced with the newest design of the timing chain, which does appear to have mostly resolved the issues. Biggest point there is this should mostly be a non-concern nowadays if you are looking at a model built after January 2015. And if you're buying an older one, look to see if the timing chain was replaced at any point, just because at this point with that 7-year, 70,000-mile extended warranty is up. However, given this was a known issue, if you do run into timing chain failure, I'm guessing you could work with BMW to at least get some resolve if you do run into that. Moving on to the next common problem for the BMW N20. This is a multi-part engine problem with the N20, and that is oil leaks. So the two main oil leaks on the N20 are the oil filter housing gasket and the valve cover gasket. Pretty straightforward, just simple gaskets that over time wear down and begin degrading. Once that happens, they start cracking and oil leaks develop. So those are really the two most common ones on the N20. However, occasionally things like the oil pan gasket or front or rear main seals may start leaking oil. A little bit less common than the valve cover and the oil filter housing gasket. However, with some of the original N20s now being over a decade old, of course, that wear and tear and the age and mileage on those, not totally uncommon for some other oil leaks to develop. Ultimately, fairly simple issue here. Unfortunately, if you do end up at a repair shop or a mechanic, sometimes these oil leaks can be expensive repairs. Like the valve cover gasket, for example, does take some time and take some labor. So if you end up at a repair shop, even though the gasket itself is about $50, you might end up spending $600 or $800, depending on what kind of repair shop you end up at, just in labor costs. So definitely a little bit added there, but if you can DIY these things, then you can save a good chunk of money on any of these oil leaks that do pop up on the N20. Moving on to problem number three is the electric water pump on the N20. So this is a common problem on many BMWs, especially of this era. If you look at engines like the N54, the N55, the N63, they all have pretty frequent water pump failures. The issue with the electric design is it uses a composite impeller, which tends to wear down a little bit faster than a traditional water pump. Now, there are upgraded water pumps that do offer a metal impeller. However, the downside with the metal impeller is that heavier impeller then is more likely to fry out the electrics in the water pump from the extra weight that it's having to spin. So just kind of one of those things. There isn't really a perfect long-term solution or fix for the N20 water pump. Roughly every 60 to 80,000 miles is about how long those water pumps last. Some might last 100,000 miles or more, and others give out even before 50,000 miles. So a little bit of a luck of a draw there, but certainly one of the most common issues on the BMW N20. Moving on to the last main item on the list for N20 common engine problems is the charge pipe, and this might not be totally fair because on a stock N20, the charge pipe isn't all that likely to fail. It does occasionally happen on stock boost, but anyway, this thin plastic pipe is just prone to cracking, and that's especially true when you start tuning and modifying the N20 and throwing more boost at it. Obviously, more boost, that charge pipe has to hold more pressure, and that makes it more likely to start running into issues with it just popping off or actually cracking the plastic. Fairly simple, you can buy an aluminum upgraded charge pipe for about $200, and that's a simple, easy, long-term fix. So if you're looking to mod the N20, would definitely recommend considering an aluminum charge pipe before you tune the N20 and really start turning boost up at all. So that wraps up the four most common problems for the BMW N20. But in summary, there are a couple important notes here. First, starting off, the N20 does offer roughly average reliability. It's not the most reliable car and engine out there. However, it's far from being the least reliable, and that's especially true compared to BMW engines of a similar era to the N20 when you look at the N54, which had a lot of common problems, in the N55, which was an improvement over the N54, but still a fairly problematic engine. You could say the same about the N20, but with it being a smaller four-cylinder engine, it certainly is a little bit easier and cheaper to maintain than the larger inline-six engines. So again, roughly average reliability for the N20, nothing terrible outside of the timing chain problems, but again, that's mostly resolved by now, but it's also not great by any means, at least compared to more reliable engines out there like Toyota, Lexus, some of those brands that are more known for reliability than a company like BMW. And again, the N20 does suffer from a lot of typical BMW engine problems like coolant leaks, the water pump, as well as oil leaks. Quite a few problems that are just kind of commonplace or standard with BMWs, especially as they get to that 8-year and 80,000 plus mile ballpark. So again, the N20, at least looking at some of the original N20s, are now over a decade old, so there are definitely some age-related problems that are going to come along with owning the N20. Anyway, that's all we have for this video today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the BMW N20. Thanks, guys.